Hi, I'm Ann Beauregard. I'm your Ward 5 City Councilor. And it's Wednesday, September 26, 2018, about 2 p.m. We've had some awful strange weather, and I hope all of you are safe as I speak to you. It's getting a little darker earlier in the evening, and also it's staying darker earlier in the morning, too. Let's all be safe out there. Everyone is back at school in the Brockton school system. So let's remember, a lot of people out there getting ready for school and going to school in the morning and in the afternoon. Let's make it safe for everyone. A whole lot is happening, most of it good, and some changes. So I'll highlight a lot of spots here. I'm going to mention, again, my name is Ann Beauregard. I'm the Ward 5 City Councilor, A. Beauregard, B-E-A-U, R-E-G-A-R-D at C-O-B-M-A.us. The City Council meetings and the Finance Committees are now being held at the Brockton High School Fine Arts Building in the Little Theater, 7 p.m. every Monday, unless it's a holiday. You're always welcome to attend. Once again, everyone's back into the September schedule, and I want to highlight the fact that we're always looking for members for our boards and commissions. If you have any interest, you can submit a letter of interest and your information on yourself to the mayor's office, and of course, you know, I'd be happy to help that along if there's a particular need or desire in your passion and to serve this community. There's always something happening. This is a city of 100,000 people. Okay, let's talk about a variety of different things. Let's remember, some of you are going to be looking for services for fuel assistance. Now's the time to start talking to the individuals you need to. Should you be over 62, 65, you might want to call the Council on Aging or Old Colony Elder Services, both located in downtown Brockton, where they would be able to assist you or visit their websites and help you navigate the services that exist and if you qualify. Also, if you're family situation, we have many agencies, but one that I highly recommend on the south side of Brockton is the Family Center right next to Trinity Baptist Church, and they would be able to assist you in many of those services. Everyone needs help sometime, and do not hesitate to go out there should you need the assistance, because there's no reason to be cold as the weather changes and your situation arises for other concerns. Please, we are here to let you know about services. These are not services provided by the city, but they are services within the city that the city can help connect you with. Okay, so again though, even though it's getting cooler, we still have to be concerned about ticks. So everyone that's been out there in their yards and whatever, please check, because Lyme disease is serious and there's more than one strand, and sometimes it's a little bit difficult and challenging to diagnose. On the other note, the flu clinics are starting to open. I saw some flyers posted at the Council on Aging, so that's for individuals 60 and over. It doesn't cost you anything. You may take advantage of it if you are a resident in the city of Brockton. Also, apparently, there'll be some taking place, these clinics, for employees of the city of Brockton. Okay, on a lighter note, we're collecting Halloween costumes throughout the city at the Brockton Main Library. Anyone doesn't fit in their Halloween costume anymore, wants something new, at the three branch and the two branches, and also at City Hall. Okay, you know, gently worn or masks or other situations you might want to hand to someone else. So please consider that. Halloween is a little more than a month away, and as far as I'm concerned, it's the best holiday. I love dressing up and I love eating candy, but we'll be back to talk more about that next month. But just to let people know and plan accordingly that all this is taking place. There's always concerns about paved roads and streets. I'm still working with other individuals in select areas to find out more about that. There's been also some concerns about street lights, and we're following up on that. The company is still in Brockton that had to replace 8,000 street lights. So needless to say, that is a little bit of a challenge, okay? Again, my name is Ann Beauregard. You may reach me at 774-297-4939, except for today because I'm apparently having cell phone problems. So anyway, we can probably try tomorrow. and everything should be all set. Again, I can also be reached at abeauregard@cobma.us. Okay, now, it's no secret that we're getting a new parking garage at the intersections of Main and Center and Main and what we refer to as Petronelli Way. Now, you've seen already the changes of Petronelli Way that is no longer 8-through way. So, and there's also a situation where there's going to be bus shuttles for those that work inside the TA, Department of Transitional Assistance, and the other state offices to get to their parking lots because everyone has been, or most people have been displaced due to this new project. A little bit more than a year and we should be back to normal. And years fly by very quickly as I talk about things, which brings me up to all the different things that are taking place. The library, public library system has changed their hours to service more residents and individuals. Remember, you can always use conference rooms for your different groups or the different, what do I call them, activities rooms or auditorium is a multi-purpose room in the 304 Main Street office. You can give a call at 508-580-7890. And if you hit 107, that's the circulation desk, they can direct you to the various individuals. Because I know there's a lot of groups here looking for a place to meet. And again, there's a whole lot of activities going on in the library system. One of them is going to be my ward meeting on Wednesday, October 3rd, beginning at 7 p.m. because now the Broughton Main Library is open till 9 o'clock on Wednesday nights from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. So love to have you there. We're going to be talking about lead paint removal, and especially in particularly in older homes and some people that could qualify for grants and assistance in that way. We're also going to have a presenter from the City Hall talking about the various forms and how to navigate them and what various departments, should you want to open a business, should you want to rent property, should you, be looking for other documents, and how to, best serve you in that case. I'll have other individuals there and elected officials that will be there to listen to your, questions and concerns. Again, that is Wednesday, October 3rd at the Broughton Main Library. This time we're going to be in the Driscoll Gallery because we have a whole lot of art exhibits taking place, which leads me to the other cultural activities taking place in this city. Okay, backwards, we're going to talk about Columbus Day weekend with the annual Tower Fest. I think we're on 15 years now with the Tower Fest, a free, fun event for the whole family. Begins at 11 a.m., and you know that there's always David's Gorman Kids Road Races that begin at 10 a.m., and they're $1 each for your children, each child, and join us for a good time. And there's going to be pumpkin painting, face painting, music, other games and activities, free pony rides. And this is all free fun for everyone from 12 to 4. We're very excited about, oh, and I forgot to mention the tower tour. So get in shape because it's an awful lot of stairs up to the top of the tower where you get to see Brockton, Avon, Stoughton, and Easton. So people don't realize all the stuff that's going on. Fuller Craft Museum has a ton of new programs and also exhibits going on. And remember, if you're lucky enough to live in Broughton, you can go into the Fuller Craft Museum through Tuesday through Sunday for free. So check it out. There's always fun things going on. And as I speak here, oh, I'm going to have to start wrapping up because there's so much great things going on. And again, my ward meeting is on Wednesday, October 3rd. I can be reached at 774-297-4939. But join us at the Downtown Broughton Fest. We're the seventh one, and we're going to have car shows, and we're going to have free events. Oh, Friday night with the boxing at the Broughton Main Library, 2 to 8, memorabilia, all kinds of displays. Good time, it's all free. And then please come and join us the next day at the marketplace from 10 to 5, music, food, art exhibits, merchants, car show, and a whole lot more. Thanks again for joining me, and thanks for being part of such a great city. And, join us for good times, and be safe, and don't hesitate, we're here to serve you.